Hey everyone, it's Tamil and I am back with another Canva tutorial. This time guys, I want to show you how to use the effect feature called Photogenic on any of your photos, and also I'm going to show you how to remove the background and add a new background to that image. So guys, that's what I'm talking about today, so let's get started. Okay, so here I am inside of a blank page inside of Canva, and the first thing that I want to do is grab a photo. So I'm going to go over here to uploads to look for a photo. What I'll use is I'll use this photo right here. I am going to drag this over, and actually I don't want the bun cut off, so I'm going to delete it. What I'll do is just click on the photo, then that way I can stretch it out how far I want, and that way my hair doesn't get cut off in the photo. I can move this down a bit and then just move this up a little bit, just like that. So that's how I want it to look. Okay, so once you have applied an image, the next thing that you want to do is you want to go up to the top right here where this bar is and click on effects. Right here inside of effects, you have several different apps that you can use for your images. You have, you know, Duotone, you have Color Mix, Liquify. Actually, I love Duotone. If you're one of those people that like to work with the crazy colors and you're okay with that, it doesn't scare you off, then Duotone is really, really awesome. You also have, you know, Liquify and Pixelate. But what I want to show you today is I want to show you this one right here called Photogenic. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And inside of Photogenic, it gives you like different moods to, you know, a photo. So since I already have this photo right here, it's going to give me what my photo would look like if it was in this particular tone that they call Flint. So if I clicked on that, then it gives me this effect right here. And then as you scroll down, you have the warm color effect, you have the cool color effect, you can add to an image, which I love this one right here, polar. You can also add really vivid colors as well. If you want something soft, you can do soft, you can do vintage. And one of the great things about these effects is if you notice right here, these lines right here actually lead to another page that shows you the controls. After you have clicked on whatever effect you want, then you can click on those lines, and what it allows you to do is to adjust the intensity. If the intensity is too much and you want to make it a little bit softer, you can do so. Hopefully you can see this, but you can adjust the intensity here. But I'm going to show you how this works on a different picture in just a second. But that's what those lines lead to. What I want to do next is I want to show you an effect that I think is really, really awesome. If you keep scrolling down all the way past all of these effects, you'll come to one that's called Color Pop. And Color Pop is definitely one that will stand out. So if you're not afraid to use colors, then this is definitely the one for you. These type of effects I've seen before, like on t-shirts of rock stars or on the cover of maybe like an album for a music artist. They like to play with colors like these. What I'm going to show you right now is a few of these. I'm going to go through so that you can see how they all look. This one right here is minty. It's going to give like a green color effect. And then you've got this one right here. And that mint is actually pretty neat. I actually like that. This next one is hibiscus. To me, it just looks like a plain photo, honestly. But this one right here is poster, and this one does look like a poster. You can tell because usually on a poster, the image itself sits out. All right, so this one right here is purple color. And like I said, you can always adjust the intensity on these things and tone it down or increase it if you want. This one right here is outrun. So I'm going to click on that one. Right here is really, really, really bright. I mean, I love the pink and the yellow. If this is something that you can work with or you think that it would be fascinating, then I definitely would try this one out. Let's look at the intensity on this. If I tone it down just a little bit, this is exactly how it would look. So I probably would keep it right in the middle. The only thing is that you have this yellow right here that sits on the cheeks and the forehead. I'm not sure if I actually like that. I actually looks better this way if it's just turned all the way up. So I think that looks cool. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to show you this one right here called Heat Wave. This is the one that we're going to be using today. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. And this is how Heat Wave would look. If you don't mind, you know, this yellow area going on, it matches what's in the background. That's perfectly fine. But I like the intensity, honestly, just where it is. And the intensity is all the way up. If I decided that I wanted to tone it down just a little bit, I could go a little bit, not even exactly halfway, but I would go a little bit further just so that I can see more blue. I would keep the intensity a little bit up. That looks really, really cool. I don't want a red face, but this looks really, really cool. I'm just going to tone it down just a tad bit right here. And actually, if I wanted to, I could make a copy of this and actually show you how it would look with the red face. Let's see how this works first. I'm going to take it down to about 64 and I'm going to go ahead and apply it. Once it's applied, then this is the type of effect that you have. And see, the great thing about this is once you apply this effect and you go back into the tab effects, you notice that all of these that said natural, warm, colors, they're all now, they're not exactly the same. They now take on the look of the new applied effect. So you can keep layering up on these if you want. And if you really know what you're doing, you can come out with a really awesome design. Okay, so now the next thing that I want to do is I want to show you how to remove the background. Because like I said, I want to remove the background and add a completely different background. And I tend to do this all the time with my YouTube thumbnails. So it's not very often that I ever use the background of any picture. I typically just remove the background and I start with a completely different design for my thumbnails and also too sometimes for my blog. So I'm going to show you exactly how you can do that as well. So if you go up to effects, and this is typically going to be for people that have Canva Pro. You will find this right here, which says background remover. So if you have Canva Pro, because it is a Canva Pro feature, then you can use the background remover. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. So this is how it looks with the background removed. Now, honestly, I must say that every single time I do this, sometimes there's always something that's different and I may end up having to do it a second or a third time. And so I won't be able to tell how this really looked until I change the background. This is how you remove the background of an image. If you do not have Canva Pro, do not worry. You can still do this because, guys, I created a video on how to remove the background of any image, especially if you do not have Canva's upgraded feature, which is the Canva Pro, you can still do this. You can check out that video. It's going to show you exactly how to create the same effect even without Canva Pro. Next, what I want to do is I want to actually add a background to this. Okay, so now let's add a background to this. You can easily find a ton of different backgrounds over here on this tab right here. I suggest that you play around with the different gradients. I mean, they're really, really cool to use. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use a gradient and I'm going to show you what it looks like. One of these right here. I want to stick with blue. So I think what I want to do is not use that one. I'm going to undo it and I'm going to use this one. This one right here blends in perfectly. I mean, if you can find the right background that has the right gradient, the right tone, then you can definitely do this. This moves from like a purple to a blue. And so you can use this gradient right here. I'm going to move this over. I think I'm going to make this a little bit smaller and I am going to leave it just like this in the corner. Actually, that's good right there. Once you have a background, then you can add whatever type of text that you want. I usually do this a lot when I create YouTube thumbnails. Usually in all of my YouTube thumbnails, I am deleting the background, removing it, from the picture, and then I tend to apply it to actually a fresh new image. I'll take this picture right here, delete the background, and I'll add it to a completely different background because I like to make my YouTube thumbnails customized. I typically do not use the original background that I took the picture on. Let's just change this and let's just add some text here. And I'll say my name. Actually, I use this all the time. My name is Tamil. And I think I'm going to change the color to this because I think it will look better white. And actually, I'm going to duplicate this just so that I can actually delete part of it. And I am going to add a different font to this. I'm going to go up here. I'm going to add that font. Then I'll pull this down. I will delete this right here. And that way I can easily just add this above it. I'm going to increase the font. You can do that up here all the way until it's just big enough to see. And 100 looks good. I'm going to move this up and then I'll move this down. And I will increase the font to this as well. I don't know how big I want to increase it, but I'll increase it to this size. Then I'm going to add some more text just for fun. And then I will. So, hi, my name is Tamil, and I will say welcome to my channel. That's it right there. This is how you use the Photogenic feature. And like I said, if you click here, you can easily go up to effects and find it. It sits up here and you can play around with this. You know, one of the great things I like about this feature is you can play around with the intensities, but it gives you like a wide variety of things to use. So you're not just using a couple effects. I mean, you have about 6 to 7 effects that you can use, and then you can layer effects on top of effects. And so this one right here is really, really neat. I'm going to color this one and add this color to it. See how it looks. That is it. Now, these are great gradients to use and to blend. Like, for example, in the background back here, you've got these nice gradients. It looks as if it's blending in with my shirt. So when you find the right background, or you can even create your own by adding a fading effect. So if you wanted to create your own background that had a, you know, blended effect like this, or a fading effect, I created a video on that as well. If you want to learn how to create a fading effect for your background, then you can definitely do that inside of Canva alongside with using the Photogenic effect and using the background remover. This is how you get really, really good at designing graphics that look extremely professional, but they're not extremely time consuming. That is it right there. I hope you like this video. Give me a thumbs up if you were really, really, really feeling this video today. And also let me know down in the comment section below if you are using Photogenic or if you are using any of these apps here. Maybe you're using Duotone, you know, constantly on all of your images, or maybe Color Mix or Liquify. Let me know down in the comment section below which one of these are your favorites to use in your designs. And lastly, guys, subscribe to my channel because I am kicking out videos just like Canva every single week. I am definitely trying to give you guys some of the best work that I've been learning from Canva and teaching you how you can do it, especially if you are a beginner. So definitely check out some more videos just like this. You can check the link down in the description below this video, or if you look up at the top corner, you will see a link there where you can watch tons of Canva tutorials that I have for you guys, and I'm steadily creating these videos every single week. All right, guys, so that is it for this video. Thanks for stopping by, and come back again. I will be putting out more videos each week just like this. All right, take care. I'll see you soon.